Ooh, Mishimoto. What came in the mail from Mishimoto for the Battlewagon? Let's open this box and find out. Must be project time. Hey guys, welcome back to Build It Motorsport. Now today, you saw it in the tagline, you saw it in the teaser, we're going to be unboxing this box I have right here from Mishimoto. If you know anything about Mishimoto, you know that Mishimoto makes intercoolers. It's one of the things they make, is intercoolers. So if you're subscribed, you know all about the Battlewagon. I encourage you guys to go back and watch some of those videos. Performance-wise, I'll leave the link above to a video you can go watch, just kind of get an idea of what's done to it. We've done a lot since the video that is tagged above, but that'll give you a good idea of what's done to it. It's a 5.7 liter Hemi Mega Cab. Cammed, full bolt-ons, got a built transmission, but it's not boosted. There's no boost. So why would I be buying an intercooler? Well, I'm going to open up this box, and when we're doing that unboxing, we're going to explain to you what the plans are for the Battlewagon moving forward. It's going to be a project that could take a few months, but we're starting with the intercooler. So here we go. Let's get to unboxing it. All right, guys. Got the box laying on the floor here so I can show you all how it is laid out on the floor. A little bit easier to see that way. So let's get to unboxing this thing. I want to go ahead and say this. I apologize if I sound a little different. It's because I've been coming over a cold. So we'll just work with it. It's not too bad now. So, first thing, let's go ahead and look and see what they sent in this little bag. Like this little box. Gotta say though, you got, look at that. Look at that. This is not just some cardboard box. That's nice. It's really nice. I gotta say, you pay a lot for these things, but it's packaged well. So, let's see what's in here. Packing slip. You don't need to see that. Oh, they were nice enough to send this little koozie. Pretty cool. Mishimoto, push the limits. Hey, that's what we're going to do. Pushing the limits of Hemi performance on my big, huge bus. Set that down over there. All right. That's a nice box. I dig it. I dig it. It looks nice. Okay. So, all right. We'll get to unboxing this thing. I'll pull it out. And I'll explain what the plans are for what's in here. All right. Wow, what do we have here? It's like an air freshener of some kind. Go ahead and rip this thing open. So it sent a little Mishimoto penguin air freshener. It's kind of cool. Probably just hold on to that. And a little pamphlet trying to sell me more stuff. Yeah, that's not important. And a rewards program. Apparently they have a rewards program. So if you're buying a lot of stuff from them, you can subscribe to their rewards program and get discounts. Looks like I didn't do that because I probably won't buy a whole lot of stuff from them. But I wanted to go with this from them, and I'll explain why. So let's get this thing open. Oh, the main event right here. Well packaged, you guys. Very well packaged. So, yes, indeed, you guessed it. It is an intercooler. So, let's pop this puppy out of here. Now, this is an intercooler. It's a really nice intercooler. 3-inch in, 3-inch out. And it's a decent size. Now, I want to explain to you guys what the plans are for this intercooler. So right now, the truck is full bolt-on, it's cammed, it's got a built transmission. Other than ported heads, there's not a whole lot we can do to the truck. There's not a whole lot we can do to it other than boost, nitrous, or port the heads. I don't really want to get ported heads. I don't want to shell out the money for that. Because even doing that, I'm not going to gain more than maybe, at the most, 30 to 40 horsepower. So, the truck as it sits right now, it's got a lot of power for a 5.7 Hemi, but it's got a lot of weight because of being a mega cab four-wheel drive truck. It's very heavy. And when we set out on this project, we knew that it was going to be hard to do to make a truck that heavy go fast. I mean, it's a lot faster than it would be stock. It's probably making, I mean, I don't want to guess on power numbers, but it's making quite a bit more power than it would be making with, you know, being stock. It's got a cam, full bolt-ons, that means headers, ported intake, it's got an oversized throttle body, the best cold air intake that I could find for it. It's got, I mean, tons of stuff, custom tuning, no cats. I mean, it's got it all. So, I don't want to go nitrous. I've ruled out nitrous. I don't want to fill the bottle. I like driving this truck. I don't want to fill the bottle all the time to go racing. I don't want to have to track down nitrous. I don't want to have to do all of that. I don't want to have to run a nitrous tune when I want to use the nitrous and then have a non-nitrous tune for when I don't want to use the nitrous. Switching back and forth between tunes, in the nitrous tune, you're going to use more power. How do I want to describe that? When you're using nitrous, you have to pull the timing. So that way the nitrous is safer. So in order to use the nitrous, you have to back off the timing. So when you're in the nitrous tune, you actually have less power if you're not using the nitrous. So I didn't want to go nitrous. It's not something I wanted to do. I wanted to have power all the time. So that left us with boost. With boost, there's basically three routes we could go. There is a turbo or turbos. Doing that, it's just there's not a lot of room to run it. If I wanted to do a turbo, I wanted it to be visible. It is a show truck in a lot of ways, so I wanted it to be visible. So we didn't want to go turbo. I don't want to go turbo. If y'all want to comment in the comments and change my mind, please change my mind. I still can go turbo. You need an intercooler with turbo. We could have gotten positive displacement supercharger. That means like a Whipple or something like that. Kenny Bell, something like that. That's going to sit on top of the intake. We wouldn't need this intercooler for that. So you can guess I'm not going to go with one of those. And they don't really make one for third gen Ram with a Hemi. I haven't seen anything out there. And I don't want to go that route. So the other option is to go with a intercooler for a centrifugal supercharger. So like a Procharger style of supercharger or a Torque Storm style of supercharger. The Prochargers come with an intercooler, so we're not going Procharger. So I'm kind of stuck between turbo or Torque Storm right now, and I'm really leaning towards Torque Storm with where we want to go. So that's kind of where I'm at right now. That's what I want to do. So let's take a look at this bad boy. Really well made. Really nice welding. It's only got the Mishimoto M on the one side. I love the welds. It looks really nice. 3-inch inlet and outlet. This is either way. It can go in this way or out that way. It doesn't matter. It's not directional. It's not going to matter. But we can take a look here. So for the power level that I'm wanting to run, realistically, the maximum horsepower that I really think that we'll be pushing out of anything that I do would probably be 700 horsepower. And right out of the gate, adding boost, it's not going to be that. That would be like an end goal. So I sized this intercooler for two things. One, needed to be able to flow the flow numbers that I would need to flow in order to make, you know, 600 horsepower or so. Something, you know, 600 horsepower, maybe a little bit more later. But wanted to have an intercooler that would flow that. And I looked and looked and looked and looked online, looked at CX Racing, and they have a really good website, CX Racing Intercoolers, really good stuff. But they didn't have, you know, anything that was packaged in a small package that would flow the numbers I wanted. Everything was too big. And for the space that I have on the truck, which we'll see that later whenever we start mounting this, there's not a lot of room up there. There's not a lot of room to mount that up in front behind the grill. So I had to have something that was, you know, a little bit smaller in size in order to make it fit. Now, basically, this is a 3-inch core. 3 inches, the most room that I have is 3 inches. So I can't really fit anything thicker than that in there. If I had a 4-inch core, then the size of it wouldn't have been a problem because the 4-inch core is going to flow more, and I wouldn't have a problem finding a intercooler that would fit, because a 4-inch, if I had that much space, wouldn't be hard to find that much flow numbers. But this is basically going to take up the entire space left to right and depth-wise for what we have to work with. This intercooler is rated at 1250 CFM, and called Mishimoto, asked them about what I'm going to be doing, and they said this would be fine. And this is basically the only intercooler I could find that would fit and have the phone numbers. I mean, really, honestly, guys, I know there are going to be haters, people telling me that's not big enough. But for what I'm trying to do, we're probably never going to go over 10 pounds of boost. So with that being said, you know, 10 pounds of boost would be probably hitting 700 or more horsepower on the truck as it sits. So this is what we're going to do, is how it's going to fit. It looks really nice. M on one side, no M on the other. You can get this in aluminum, and you can also get it in the black like I have here. All of them have the M on one side and not on the other. And the reason for that is maybe I want the M showing. Maybe I want to put it in there like this and not have it showing. So that's all kind of how showboaty do you want to be. I didn't want to go with the aluminum one because everything behind the hood's black. And spoiler alert, guys, I'm not going to run the M except for maybe flip it around before a show or something. It won't be that hard to do the way I'm planning on setting this up. But got 3-inch inlets, outlets, side tanks, which are not really tanks, but the end, you know, end tanks. They're really well welded. I love it. This is, according to Mishimoto, it's powder coated black, and I'm guessing this white is just paint here. We've got really nice mounting bosses that are threaded. Careful not to use too long of bolts, or you'll go through the deal. This is a bar and plate intercooler, so it's real heavy. Like, this thing's got some weight to it. Got mounting bosses there and there, and on the top as well. So this should mount nice and sturdy. And check that out. That's nice. Like, good. Open up the hood, look on top there, and you're going to see that label. Mishimoto. You know, that's a good brand. That's a really good brand, but you pay the price to get quality stuff. But I needed to have something that would have the flow numbers I was looking for, but also fit the space I was looking for. And the only place I could find that, without a doubt, specified the flow numbers and the size and was fitting to what I was looking for was this intercooler right here. So this is the G-Line, Mishimoto G-Line intercooler. And it's not really big. Let me grab a tape measure and I'll show you the measurements real quick. And then we'll see how well it fits behind the hood real quick. If it's not too dark outside. So overall length is coming in right at 25 inches. That's 25 inches right there on the dot. Of course, the caps are on it. But 25 inches is the overall width. The actual core itself is about 18, looks like. Just under 18 inches. Top to bottom, it is, looks like it comes in right at 1 foot. So 12 inches top to bottom. And the width is supposed to be 3 inches, and it is. So that's what we're looking at. It's 25, which should fit in the space I've got. 3 inches, that's enough room to fit behind there. It's kind of narrow. 3 inches, about as much as I can get away with. And then it is 1 foot tall. I was looking for something that was taller with the same dimensions, but just taller. I couldn't find anything that was not. Anything that was taller than this was like way taller. So hopefully this will work. I think it's going to be good enough for what we're trying to do. If not, we'll figure something out. But in the next video, I'm going to mount this. I'm going to make mounts for it. We're going to mount it to the in front of the radiator and everything, like you're supposed to behind the grill. So we're going to make custom mounts. I've got a plan for that. So in the next video, we're going to go over that, and we're going to talk about what we're trying to do. But you guys, this marks the beginning of a long build that's going to go over the winter and possibly into the spring on just slowly piecing things together until we can finally get the one thing that's going to actually deliver the boost, either the torque storm or turbo system. So you guys in the comments, if you don't mind, tell me what you think. Should I go turbo? Should I go torque storm? Give me a reason why. And or maybe give me a reason why you don't like the other option. So, but yeah, if you guys want to subscribe, we're going to be doing this over the course of probably 3 or 4 months through the winter at the least. And got a lot of stuff that has to happen to make boost happen on this third gen Ram with the Hemi. So you guys stay tuned, stay subscribed, and we'll see what happens next. Thank you for watching Build It Motorsport. See you on the next one. We'll be right back.